Hello, good morning students, and welcome back to another video for the class 10, Magnetic Effects of Electric Current. So in the previous video, we just saw the beginning of the chapter, that was Oersted's experiment and how a simple straight conductor creates magnetic field around itself. In this video, we'll be talking about the magnetic field, okay, or the magnetic region surrounding a magnet. So we have studied about the magnetic force and other forces previously in the 8th standard, where we studied about non-contact forces, and magnetic force was one of the non-contact force. Magnetic force, okay. So a magnet creates a magnetic force, and when you bring a metallic object or a magnetic object near a bar magnet, for example, then after at a certain point, the magnet will attract the object by itself. So let's say that if we have a bar magnet like this, okay, which has two poles, and we know that it has a certain region around it. Let's say that this is the region, and in this region, if you try to bring a magnetic object, for example, let's say an iron nail, a simple iron nail, which looks somewhat like this, okay, and you slowly push this iron nail towards the magnet. You're keeping the magnet fixed and bringing the nail slowly towards it. As soon as you enter a certain part or near a magnet, a certain region, then the nail will get attracted to the magnet easily, okay, and very rapidly. So this certain region around a magnet is known as magnetic field. How do you define a magnetic field? A region surrounding a magnet in which its magnetic field can be experienced or felt is known as magnetic field. I repeat once again, the region surrounding a magnet in which its magnetic force can be experienced or felt is known as magnetic field. Okay, I hope that is clear to you, students. Now this magnetic field, as we know, creates the magnetic force, and we studied in 9th standard that magnetic force or any type of force is actually a vector quantity which has a particular direction. Okay, similarly, this magnetic field is made up of invisible lines which actually create the magnetic field. I repeat once again, this magnetic field is made up of magnetic field lines. Those are invisible lines which actually create the magnetic field and the magnetic force around a magnet. Okay, this magnetic field lines has a certain properties, and they are in the form of loops around a magnet. Now, how do you see a magnetic field lines? For that, we perform an activity that has been given in the textbook. Okay, we take a bar magnet and place it on a cardboard. Keeping this magnet on the cardboard, and then we sprinkle iron filings, small particles of iron. Okay, we sprinkle the iron filings everywhere around the bar magnet, and then when we tap the cardboard slowly, okay, we are tapping the cardboard, and then we will observe that this magnetic this iron filings arrange themselves in the pattern, and this patterns represent the magnetic field lines. So even though they cannot be seen directly, we can observe the magnetic field lines with the help of iron filings, and the iron filings will arrange themselves somewhat like this. Okay. So the iron filings will arrange themselves in this pattern, and this pattern describes or defines the magnetic field lines. Those are invisible lines which actually create the magnetic field. Okay, so magnetic field is made up of these magnetic field lines, Just like a pile of sand is made up of small sand particles, in the same way this magnetic field is made up of many field lines. Okay, coming out of the magnet. Now, this magnetic field lines can be described in a pattern like this. We don't need iron fillings every single time to describe the magnetic field lines. They can be expressed like this. Okay, these are the magnetic field lines. Now, of course, like I said, any type of force has a certain direction, and so this magnetic field lines also has direction. And in order to find the direction, we will use a small magnetic compass. Okay, that means we will take the help of needle magnet. Now, we know that the magnetic field lines are somewhat in this pattern, but we need to find the direction of the magnetic field lines. So what we will do, we will place the compass near the bar magnet, and then we will change its position according to the pattern. So we know that it is somewhat in a semicircular shape, so we will move the compass again and again. So on the first step, we keep the compass over here like this, then we keep on changing its position. And this is how we go step by step changing the position of a compass. The needle of the magnet in a compass, a simple needle, is a needle magnet, and the arrow is north pole, and the back end of the arrow is the south pole of this needle magnet. It is also a type of bar magnet. And so over here, as soon as you keep the compass, then it will arrange itself in this manner. That means the north is over here and south over here. So south and north attracts each other, and that is why we will get this direction. As we move forward, this will be like this. Okay? If you see the pattern, you can understand that the field line is coming like this. But the important bit is that the arrows give us the direction of the magnetic field lines. So, the magnetic field lines are going in this direction. So, if we remove the compass and we place it in the downward direction, then also we can say that the magnetic field lines are coming from north direction and entering in the south direction. So, they are coming from north pole and then entering the south pole. This is the direction of the magnet. Every single time the field lines emerge from the north pole and they enter the south pole. I hope this is clear to you, students. Very simple magnetic field lines. Okay?